Established in 1931 by inventor Dr. Herman DeVry, our university thrives on developing hands-on, career-driven programs that help elevate students. For 90 years, students have trusted DeVry University and also turned to our Keller Graduate School of Management for nearly 50 years to take the next step. We're glad you took that step with us to prepare to advance in your industry. You've experienced a personalized academic journey, working with our advisors and colleagues who know you by name and have walked with you from application to now. Everyone, from your academic advisors to your professors, and those you couldn't wait to greet in class or online, are looking at you with pride, because you did it. Every commencement is a momentous occasion and marks a milestone in your life, one that helps open doors for your future. So today, let's celebrate that you will soon be awarded one of the more than 300,000 degrees DeVry University and its Keller Graduate School of Management have awarded, and will soon join a class of those who are proud to call themselves DeVry alumni. We're excited to add your accomplishments and experience to that number, because we are proud to call you a graduate. This is a big step you've taken, and a great accomplishment. Celebrate today, but never forget why you came here in the first place. You're here, graduating. What's next? Congratulations on your well-deserved success, and best wishes for your next adventure.
Welcome to the July 2021 commencement exercises of DeVry University and its Keller Graduate School of Management. It is such an honor to welcome you today on behalf of the faculty and staff of our campuses and online programs as we celebrate our 90th anniversary since our founding in 1931. Before we begin, we would like to remind you that throughout this ceremony, a text and tweet wall will be available. You are invited to text your positive and congratulatory messages for the graduates, and these tweets and messages will be shared on the screen. We encourage all of our graduates and guests to start texting and tweeting using the information you will see on your screen. At this time, we would like to take a moment to recognize those who currently serve or have served our country. If you are a student, staff or guest at today's event, and you have or are currently serving in our nation's military, we recognize you and thank you for your service. Please stand for the singing of our national anthem by Stacy Fox Uwadia.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets rose out glare, the bombs bursting in air gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the
now our pleasure to introduce the President and CEO of DeVry University and its Keller Graduate School of Management, Tom Monahan.
Family members, alumni, distinguished faculty, and most importantly, graduates, hello and welcome. It's a tremendous honor for me to be able to speak to you today. Graduation is a momentous occasion, a chance to think back on your journey to this point, to celebrate your accomplishment, and of course, to look ahead. All those late nights juggling work and family responsibilities, the tests, the papers, the reading, all that hard work has paid off. And I'd like to say that the hard work is behind you, but as we all know, commencement means to begin, not to complete. And to make matters worse, I'm even going to use my presence prerogative to give you three last assignments. While I would of course prefer to be with you in person, I'm actually glad I can't hear the collective groan that the phrase more assignments would produce. Don't worry, they aren't too taxing, especially relative to all the hard work you've done to date. This achievement would be worthy of note at any time, but you and your fellow students have reached this milestone against the backdrop of a truly unprecedented time in history. Across the last 18 months, we have seen a global pandemic take millions of lives and bring everyday life as we know it to a complete halt. I can say with complete confidence that every single member of our community has been affected. Some of you were directly touched by the disease. Some lost loved ones. Some served on the front lines in the healthcare sector or the retail and distribution sector. Many became teachers as their school children left the classroom or took on additional care responsibilities. The list of impacts could go on, but the larger point is simple. Reaching an educational goal of this magnitude always requires perseverance. But you have shown resilience almost sure to be unmatched in DeVry's or higher education's history. The last year provided many potential reasons to fall short of your educational goals, all of them legitimate. And yet you are here today because you would not be distracted or deterred. This resolution and focus, in the face of an unprecedented set of headwinds, is an asset that you've always had within you. But now you know how to summon it and use it to accomplish your most important objectives. This brings us to the first of the assignments. Write a note to your future self. Even on a day of celebration like today, we all know there will be hard times ahead. Promotions that get delayed, business ideas that don't get traction, family challenges that could create additional burdens. I wish I could tell you this new credential would sweep those moments away, but it won't. What I can guarantee, however, is that the resolve and focus you have shown in these times will serve you every bit as well in those times. Find time amidst these celebrations to write a quick note to your future self. Remind yourself that you have shown remarkable resilience, focus, and resolve in the face of some incredible obstacles. And you know that you can push forward through whatever lies ahead. We also know that you didn't accomplish this objective alone. One of the most meaningful elements of a commencement celebration is that it brings together many of the people vital to your success at DeVry and in all your communities. Not only within the DeVry and Keller community, classmates, dedicated faculty, student support teams, but within your personal communities, the caring figures in your life who have lifted you up to where you are today. Your family members, siblings, husbands, wives, partners, significant others, your children, colleagues at work, colleagues from previous experiences, old teachers, each of them shares in your accomplishment today. And each of them will be vital to your success going forward. I love the pictures and videos I have seen from so many of you over the past weeks as you and yours have prepared for this special day. So much creativity and so much pride and love. It just goes to show that no matter where we are, our community surrounds us, keeps us strong, and pushes us to achieve great things. And here comes assignment number two. Find time to express gratitude, whether it be through a note, a gesture, a conversation. Make time to thank the most important people in your corner. As I mentioned before, commencement means a beginning. What we celebrate today is not just the attainment of new skills, new insights, and new credentials, but the opportunity to put those assets to work. The Greek mathematician Archimedes said, "Give me a place to stand and a lever long enough, and I can move the world." I'd like to think the people around you today have lifted you up and given you an incredible platform on which to stand. And I believe the learning that you've done in your classes here have given you a powerful lever. And goodness knows, this is a world in need of moving on any number of dimensions. The pandemic has illustrated so many opportunities for impact, from management and innovation in our health sector, to new applications of rapidly advancing technology, to new, more inclusive, and more innovative ways of managing and working. There simply couldn't be a better or more important time for this group of uniquely motivated, uniquely resilient, and uniquely skilled people to launch into their next phase of impact. And here comes assignment number three. Plan to pay it forward. As you put your education to work, and grow in your professional impact, find a way to be a role model and mentor to the next generation, which could mean your own children, family members, younger colleagues, or maybe even future university students studying in your field. As you get ready to take your next steps, know that I and the rest of your DeVry community are here with you every step of the way. Not only will you carry forward a valuable set of skills from classes into the world, but you will have access to a variety, personalized set of specialized resources to support and accelerate your career journey. You've made us all DeVry proud. Congratulations, class of 2021. We can't wait to see what you do next. It is now my pleasure to present a congratulatory message on behalf of the DeVry University and Keller Graduate School of Management Alumni Association.
Welcome, graduates. Welcome to the DeVry alumni family. You did the hard work. You made the sacrifice. And that's what makes you family.
Hope that you follow your passions, you maintain your role as lifelong learners, and you continue to work hard as you did at DeVry or Keller.
Congratulations to the graduates.
Hello, the class of 2021. You made it. Yes.
Congratulations, graduates. You can be DeVry proud.
Congratulations, graduates, and welcome to the alumni family.
Congratulations, graduates. You can be DeVry proud because you have overcome so many obstacles to reach this very important milestone. Welcome to the alumni family.
I am especially proud of each and every one of you. I can only imagine the amount of sacrifice, the late days and nights studying, the love, sweat, and tears you all had to endure to reach this huge milestone. Therefore, it's worth celebrating.
I want you to always be proud, but most importantly, I want you to always carry a sense of being DeVry proud.
Congratulations to the class of 2021, and welcome to the worldwide alumni family.
We would now like to introduce Dr. Dana Bourne, member of the DeVry University Board of Trustees and co-director of the Center of Public Leadership at the Harvard Kennedy School of Government.
Thank you. It is my great honor to introduce your commencement keynote speaker, three-time Olympian, three-time Olympic medalist, four-time world champion, and Keller alumna, Alana Myers-Taylor. The daughter of a professional football player, Alana was born in Oceanside, California, but grew up in Douglasville, Georgia. A naturally gifted athlete across many sports, Alana was drawn to softball. And by age 9, she declared her intention to become an Olympian. She attended George Washington University on a softball scholarship and went on to play professionally before transitioning into the high-speed sport of bobsled. I'll let her tell you how that happened in her life journey. In 2015, Alana made history, becoming the first woman to earn a spot on the U.S. national team competing with the men. As a four-man bobsled pilot, she went on to become the first woman to win a medal in international competition in a men's event. And that same year, she won the world championship in the two-woman event, the first woman in U.S. history to do so. To date, she's prepared to return to the Olympic Games in 2022, and she's the only female U.S. bobsled athlete to win three Olympic medals. Alana holds an undergraduate degree in sports science from George Washington University, where she also earned a master's degree in sports management. During the peak of her athletic career, she also pursued her MBA degree at Keller Graduate School of Management, focusing on finance. Throughout her extensive training and competition schedule, Alana persevered and earned her MBA in 2015. That same summer, Alana worked in finance with the International Olympic Committee in Switzerland, and in 2018 was the president of the Women's Sports Foundation, And ultimately, Alana aspires to be the CEO of the U.S. Olympic and Paralympic Committee, for which all of her background and education has prepared her for this role of a lifetime. A fun fact about Alana, her husband, former bobsledder Nick Taylor, proposed to her on the 2013 World Championships podium when she won silver. But she walked off the podium with a diamond, and they married in 2014. And in February of 2020, they welcomed their first child, Nico, into the world. Alana has high aspirations, both for her sport and her career. And while we look forward to possibly seeing her on the bobsled ice this winter, we also hope to see her at the helm of Team USA one day. Ladies and gentlemen, Alana Myers-Taylor.
Today, I want to share with you three quick stories. Just three stories, no big deal. So I'll get right to it. The first story is about a very, very bad day. So bad that for a while, I considered it to be the worst day of my life. It happened in the spring of 2008. At that time, I was an elite softball player, and I was trying out for the U.S. Olympic softball team, the team that would get to go to the 2018 Olympic Games in Beijing, China, later that summer, and compete for a gold medal on the biggest sporting stage in the world. That was my dream, and I had earned the right to be there. I had played softball my entire life. I had earned a college scholarship, and my dad was a professional football player. Athletics was literally a part of my DNA, and I was very, very good. Except not on that day. On that day, in fact, I was very, very bad. I have since referred to that tryout as the worst tryout in the history of tryouts. I struck out literally and metaphorically, and with that, my Olympic dream died. And it's worth noting that at that time, it had already been announced that after the Beijing Olympic Games, softball would no longer be a part of the Olympics. Beijing would be the last time. So for me, there would be no second chance. That was it. It was over. It was the end of the road. For all you parents listening today, you can imagine the unenviable position that put my father in as we sat in the car at the end of the day, and I cried pain tears of someone whose world had just come to a crashing halt. For my second story, I'll jump ahead to the fall of 2014, and I'm in Park City, Utah. Many years earlier, I had found my way to the high-speed, occasionally dangerous sport of bobsled. For those of you who have yet to have the pleasure of experiencing the thrill of hurling yourself down a mile-long ice chute covered in a covered sled of 350 pounds, it's like the feeling you get when you're driving a little bit too fast on snow-covered roads. It's a lot of fun, but you're never quite sure when things might go terribly wrong. When you get to the bottom, it's often a mix of emotions. Both, wow, I'm glad that's over, and wow, let's do it again. It's worth noting that at this point, I'm now a two-time Olympic medalist, having just won my second Olympic medal a few months earlier in the Sochi Olympic Games in Russia. So at this point, I'm not a rookie. I'm far from it. By this time, myself and many other women had been lobbying the International Bobsled Federation, the group that governs our sport on the international level, to allow women to compete in the four-man division. You see, up until this point, women were allowed to compete in the two-man competition, whereas the men competed in both the two-man and the four-man. It's the four-man competition you see the most often on TV. It's super exciting. That's where all the guys push, jump in the sled, one of them is driving, and then off they go. Well, the old boys club running the show at bobsled thought a four-man sled was too dangerous for women. We couldn't handle it because, I don't know, I guess they actually believed that women can't drive. By the way, driving the smaller sled, the two-man version, in which I won both of my Olympic medals, is actually much more difficult to drive because it's lighter. But nevertheless, I digress. They thought the four-man was too much for the fair sex to handle. Well, after making a lot of noise about it for a lot of years, they finally gave in and said, okay, you can try. Little did they know that getting permission to compete, I took that piece of advice and would... And that would actually be the easiest part of the fight. I now have the chance to compete with the big boys. And oftentimes, very big boys. That is, so long as I can get three of those big boys to join my team. And honestly, I couldn't. I'm serious. No one would push for me. I was a week away from trying out for the U.S. national team in the four-man event. I'm a two-time Olympic medalist, and nobody, I mean nobody, wanted to push for me. I was stunned. I could be your ticket onto the national team, and you don't want to push with me because I'm a woman? I mean, despite me assuring them, guaranteeing them that my uterus definitely would not fall out as we raced down the track, I still couldn't get any takers. So here I am with the opportunity to make history, but no one wanted to give me a hand. I called my husband Nick, who had been an elite bobsledder himself, who was doing some coaching in Arizona at the time, just taking some time away from the sport. My knight in shining spandex showed up the next day, ready to push for me. And in pretty short order, he rallied two other guys to join my team. Honestly, to this day, I'm really not sure if those guys joined to push me or they just wanted to push with my husband Nick. I think it was the latter. But either way, doesn't matter. I had a team at last. It might have been a little bit like the Bad News Bears of bobsled, but it was enough to get me into the race. We had a few practice runs before the competition that day, and all didn't go to plan, including one run in which my number three guy, the third guy getting in the sled, tried to jump in and missed. So we went down the track, just the three of us, and he went down on his belly like a penguin. Come race day, Nick warned me that the start house, the locker room where all the competitors get before the race, would not make any special accommodations for me as a woman. And that these guys would do anything they can, the ones I was competing against, to try and get into my head and get under my skin. And oh my goodness, he was absolutely right. Some of the things that were said to me and around me, I didn't even know words could be put together like this in the English language in such a manner to express vulgarities that I heard. And at the time, they were beyond my comprehension. This stuff would have made Snoop Dogg blush. So if you could have seen me, I just put on my headphones, cranked up my Taylor Swift, and literally just decided to shake it off. Listen to Shake It Off and everything, and I shook it off and focused on what I needed to do. When it came my time to race, I stepped out of the start house and was greeted by a big collection of women lined up all around, holding all kinds of signs of encouragement and cheering me on. It was amazing, and it was such a cool moment, and it was such an enormous environment change, like a 180 degrees, all in a few steps from the locker room to the starting line. In order to make the U.S. national team, my sled had to finish in the top three. My three pushers, including Nick, who was the last guy to get in my sled, had to give everything they had to start to get us going. But once we all jumped in, the rest was literally in my hands. By the time it was all over, we did it. We finished third place in front of the fourth place team by just 0.02 of a second. That's 0.02 seconds. That sliver of time, virtually imperceptible, turned out to be an enormous margin of victory, not just for me, but for women in the sport. I danced around the finish line singing, "You got beat by a girl, you got beat by a girl." And I made all the guys I just beat turn in their man cards and wear pink for the rest of the day. Okay, no, I'm just kidding. I didn't do that. I sure thought about it, though. As you can imagine, it was an incredible moment and an incredible day. But the memory that stands out the most to this day, to me is getting to do something with my husband. And we did it together. It was a big step for women that a really good man helped to make happen. The last story I want to share with you is brief. And it isn't about bobsled or sports at all. It's about something far more important. Last year, just about the time the pandemic was really coming into radar for the most of us here in the U.S., I was pregnant with my son, Nico. It was a difficult pregnancy with many complications. Nico was born 4 weeks early and spent the first 8 days of his life in the NICU fighting to survive. When you are chasing Olympic medals, fractions of a single second make all the difference in the world. But I can tell you that when you are helplessly watching your newborn child cling to life for 8 days, it's an eternity, and it's all that matters in the world. For our many, many prayers were answered, and it was indeed a miracle. On March 1st of last year, Nico came home for the very first time. I share these stories with you today because they demonstrate key moments in my life when I learn pieces of the skill that I consider to be the single biggest reason for the successes I've enjoyed in my life so far. These moments taught me resilience. When my softball dream went up in smoke, I had to pivot to bobsled to keep my Olympic dreams alive. Pivot. There is a word we've all heard many times this year. When there was a collection of gentlemen actively trying to distract me, to derail me, to get inside my head, well, I had to shake it off and stay focused on what I was trying to accomplish. And as I watched my newborn son struggle to survive, well, I'm sure you can imagine, it was a poignant reminder of the things that truly matter in life, of which an Olympic medal really is not one. Throughout my life, I've always considered myself to be a pretty big, strong woman. But as I watched my small little infant fight for his life and win, I was reminded that the strength on the outside is nothing compared to the strength that comes from within. And so, as I think about you, the graduates of 2021 of DeVry University, I hope that you recognize that all of the many things that you have already learned, resilience is among them. If it wasn't, you would not be here today. What took me a whole career to learn, you have fast-tracked in this unprecedented year. Never in the history of modern man has a graduating class had to endure the sort of challenges that you all did. A global pandemic that disrupted everything we once knew as normal. It affected all of us differently. But one thing you share with all your fellow graduates is that despite these challenges, you figured it out. You did it. You are resilient. Today is proof of that. I hope today is great. I hope you have a great day. You deserve it. But make no mistake about it. Your disastrous softball trial is likely coming at some point. There will be people who try to distract you from your ambitions. And you might even come face to face with a life or death situation. It's my hope that when any of those things happen, you take a moment to think back to today. And remember the resilience that lives inside of you. I believe if you do so and you learn, lean on that resilience and continue to develop it throughout your life, that ultimately it will carry you on your own personal gold medal moment. Thank you again for allowing me to be a part of this important day, and congratulations to the class of 2021.
We would now like to introduce your graduate student speaker, Lisa Johnson. Lisa is graduating with a master's in business administration and concentration in project management. Lisa was chosen for this honor by a panel of faculty and deans.
Greetings and salutations to the esteemed president and CEO of DeVry University and Keller Graduate School of Management, Board of Trustees, Collegiate Executives of Staff, officiants, and honored guests. But most of all, to the graduating class of 2021, my name is Lisa Johnson, and it is my extreme honor and privilege to address you today. This moment in time represents a significant milestone for all of us. We have gone above and beyond to post into those discussion threads. We have submitted assignments at the 11th hour on Sunday Mountain Time to ensure that they will be received. We have studied long and hard to meet this day. We have managed to juggle work, family obligations, community involvement, and schoolwork in such a way that made it seem like we were superhuman at times. Well, today begins our journey to perhaps some level of normalcy and true balance. We have met the obligations, and we have completed the requirements that allow each of us to embrace, appreciate, and savor this moment in time. For the better part of our journey, we were able to study both on-site and or online. However, due to the COVID-19 crisis in 2020, it forced all of us to online only. And we realized in that, making that adjustment, we realized our ability to stay the course and remain steadfast. We decided that we were not going to give up, and we weren't going to let what was happening around us to discourage us from reaching our goals. You know what? Commencement is an opportunity to really reflect on how we got here. As I reflect on my journey, it started in September of 1987. When I completed 2 years of college, life happened. But I always wanted to secure my college degree. So when I regrouped and it was July 2011, I started working towards my bachelor's degree right here at DeVry University. And in June of 2014, I completed the requirements and I earned my bachelor's degree in business administration with a concentration in human resources administration. But you know what? Life happened again. And in July of 2017, I finally started working towards my master's degree. And in October of 2020, I completed the requirements, and now I have also earned my MBA with a concentration in project management. You know something? When I say that life happened, I only mean that, you know, my path to the goal shifted this way and that, but my goal stayed the same. Life will intervene, as it has for many of you. Life is going to try to take us off course, but we must remain steadfast and we must persevere no matter what life brings our way. As I close this address, I wish to share three B's with you that have helped me, and I hope that they help you too. Number one, be honest. When you are honest, you never have to remember what you said, and people will be able to trust your character and integrity. Number two, be diligent. When you are diligent, you are considered trustworthy because you handle things with care. And last, be consistent. When you are consistent, you are steady and unchanging. And these are qualities that people will be able to rely on. Honesty, diligence, and consistency are characteristics that your family, friends, loved ones, as well as your employers and colleagues will be able to appreciate about you. And I believe sincerely that if you apply these three B's, you will no doubt have great success in your future. Thank you for allowing me the opportunity to share this address with you. And congratulations to each and every one of you for meeting this moment in time.
We would now like to introduce your undergraduate student speaker, Brittany Wright. Brittany is graduating with an undergraduate certificate in medical billing and coding and has already begun a new degree program pursuing her Bachelor of Science degree in technical management with a concentration in health information management. Brittany was chosen for this honor by a panel of faculty and deans.
Honored guests, fellow graduates, family and friends, I want to thank you all for being here today as we celebrate a momentous occasion. My name is Brittany Wright, and today we celebrate a new beginning, a new start in life. My fellow graduates, I am honored to be speaking on behalf of you today. I am so humbled and wish you the best that life can offer. I also want to thank the DeVry University professors who shared their wisdom and the amazing team who went above all else to ensure greatness in our lives. Lastly, I want to thank all the family and friends who have given their support, dedication, and influence to help us reach our goals. You all have been our steady ground and deserve every ounce of our gratitude. When I first started this journey in November of 2020, I had doubts. Those doubts filled me with a question such as, what if I can't? However, DeVry was there with the answer. You can, and you will succeed. They did this by providing professors who taught me that every mistake made is a learning experience and not something that defines you. DeVry also provided academic advisors who worked hard to keep me focused and incredible tutors who were my guiding light when things seemed difficult. I will forever cherish my time here at DeVry University and look forward to continuing my education through the bachelor's program. Throughout this journey, my fellow graduates and I have faced many trials. We have faced fears, losses, and different life changes in our short time here at DeVry University. However, through all the hardships, we have proven that we can overcome them. We took those hardships and used them to fuel ourselves for this very day. By doing so, my fellow graduates, we are victorious. When I started writing this speech, I came across a quote written by Ricky Rogers, who wrote, "Strength doesn't come from what you can do. It comes from overcoming the things you once thought you couldn't." This quote inspired me, as it shows that facing challenges in our lives is what strengthens us. My fellow graduates, look at the accomplishments you have achieved, at the success of your labors. To those who believe this to be the end of our journey, I must disagree. It is not the end, but the beginning of a new adventure. Nothing is impossible or unachievable to you, fellow graduates. As you are an inspiration, you are the overcomers. As I close, fellow graduates, I have treasured the time spent with you. School assignments, DeVry community chats, and even the occasional struggles we have faced together. As we say goodbye to the past, I hope that we are ready to begin life's next challenge. I wish you all the very best with all of my heart and soul. Congratulations, class of 2021.
Thank you. At this time, we would like to introduce Dr. Daryl Field, Associate Provost of Academic Operations.
Thank you to all of our guest speakers. We've now come to that very important part of today's program, in which we have the honor of presenting the candidates for graduation. Before we begin, we'd like to take a moment to recognize our distinguished faculty members for their commitment to academic quality and the support that they have provided to all of our graduates. You will find a list of our dedicated faculty in the commencement program that was provided for you for download. For our Keller Graduate School of Management students, part of your regalia traditionally includes a colorful hood. The hood is a very special part of the academic regalia that denotes scholarly and professional achievements. As our candidates for master's degrees are presented, We ask those family members or loved ones who are present to hood the graduates when their name is spoken. This is considered to be a symbol of passage from student to master. Also, as the candidates are presented, we'll identify student awards the graduates are receiving, as well as the honors of the graduates as indicated in the commencement program. At this time, we present the candidates for graduation in the College of Business and Management, the College of Engineering and Information Sciences, the College of Liberal Arts and Sciences, the College of Health Sciences, and the College of Media Arts and Technology.
The Keller Graduate School of Management. College of Business and Management. Master of Science in Accounting.
Kamika Beckford. With distinction. Sonia LaShawn Bryant. With distinction. Sonia Carr. Maria Contreras. Curtis Nathan Cody. Amy Duke. With distinction. Dwayne Johnson. Alexis G. Kelly. Hemani Patel. With distinction. Ahmad Khalil Shobash. With distinction. Tiffany Vincent. With distinction.
Master of Accounting and Financial Management.
Muhammad Dali. Ebiaboia Ebikim. Verna Latrice Franks. With distinction. Pauline Fraser. With distinction. Annette Green. With distinction. LaTanya Kimball. With distinction. Iyad Nasri. With distinction. Specios and Dagieri. Chaya G. Patel. With distinction. Krishna Patel. With distinction. Yania Rivero. With distinction. Christine Delgado Caliag Rosario. With distinction. Shamika Stinson. With distinction. Bikram Tharu. With distinction. Radhames Miguel Villafana. Trevor Walker. With distinction. Antonia Wiley. With distinction.
Master of Business Administration.
Adinka Agbola. With distinction. Ceci Agosa. With distinction. Mabalaji Alaka. Yusef El Saleh, with distinction. Nazleen Amiri. Vanessa Arambula, with distinction. Ashley Marie Barklift, with distinction. Fila Bates, with distinction. Christy Bernard. Maurice Betts. Marita Bivens. With distinction. Tyler Bonner. With distinction. Brian Bowman. With distinction. Susan Brown. With distinction. Valencia Shanice Brown. Elizabeth Brown Montgomery. With distinction. James Daytona Birch Jr. Kimberly Burdine, with distinction. Artesia Burnett, with distinction. Sandra Caldwell. Letitia Carroll. Alicia Castillo, with distinction. Camila Chmiel, with distinction. Anil Christian, with distinction. Jeremy Clark. Kwashi Collier. Tanzania Kusar Tracy. With distinction. Marlene Cruz. With distinction. Francesca Cunningham. Nikki Ira Umba Dasau, with distinction. Deanna Denton Taylor, with distinction. Sarah K. DiStefano. Avani Denani, with distinction. Babatunde Eric Bogbo, with distinction. Melissa Follow of Argus, with distinction. Courtney Gaino. Michelle Garza, with distinction. Toya Glenn, with distinction. Latoria Green. Natasha Green.
Natasha Green.
With distinction.
With distinction.
Janetta Harris.
Janetta Harris.
With distinction.
Distinction.
Nikki Harris.
Nikki Harris.
Keely Heiser.
Keely Heiser.
Cassandra Henwood.
Cassandra Henwood.
Lakeisha Highkeaton.
Lakeisha Highkeaton.
With distinction.
With distinction.
Erline Hippolyte Pedroso.
Erline Hippolyte Pedroso.
With distinction.
Distinction.
Praful Iyer.
Praful Iyer.
With distinction.
Distinction.
Chi Anthony Gino Jefferson,
Jefferson
Jr. With distinction.
With distinction.
Don Joseph.
Don Joseph.
Rontricia Jaluk.
Rontricia Jaluk.
Noreen Kafarkas. With distinction.
With distinction.
Monica Kowalski.
Monica Kowalski.
Jenna Lambrecht.
Jenna Lambrecht.
Dwayne Lehman.
Dwayne Lehman.
With distinction.
With distinction.
Michelle Liddell.
Michelle Liddell.
With distinction.
With distinction.
Tam Ma.
Tam Ma.
With distinction.
With distinction.
Todd Meldrum.
Todd Meldrum.
With distinction.
With distinction.
Denise Mamadou.
Denise Mamadou.
With distinction.
Distinction.
Shikendra Moore.
Shikendra Moore.
Victor Moreno.
Victor Moreno.
Ruth Miles.
Miles.
My Nelson.
Nelson.
With distinction.
With distinction.
Monica Nkoma.
Monica Nkoma.
Bertrice Okwozabon.
Bertrice Okwozabon.
With distinction.
With distinction.
Leah Jean Olvera.
Leah Jean Olvera.
With distinction.
With distinction.
Carla Ortiz.
Carla Ortiz.
With distinction.
With distinction.
Purr of Dorge Oyungurl.
Dorge Oyungurl.
With distinction.
Distinction.
Edgar Pardo.
Edgar Pardo.
Florida Luna Pasia.
Luna Pasia.
With distinction.
With distinction.
Krishna Patel.
Krishna Patel.
With distinction. Christopher Pillai.
Christopher Pillai.
With distinction.
Distinction.
Eric Poole.
Eric.
With distinction.
Distinction.
Tashiria Prince.
Tashiria Prince.
With distinction.
Distinction.
Suttony Promdeeridge.
Promdeeridge.
With distinction. Selmeg Purevdirge.
Selmeg Purevdirge.
With distinction.
Distinction.
Naim Kabaha.
In Kabaha.
Taylor Quinn.
Taylor Quinn.
Sabika Raza, with distinction. Roland Ricardo, with distinction. Jordan Richardson. Athena Nice Rivers. Jamie Rodriguez. Jonathan Ross. With distinction. Maria Del Carmen Ruiz. With distinction. Mallory Shoemaker. With distinction. Luther Smith Jr. With distinction. Aaron Smith. With distinction. TJ Smith. With distinction. Jasmine Samirio. With distinction. Eric Stortz. With distinction. Kenya Taylor. With distinction. Tequila Taylor. With distinction. Anthony Terrazas. With distinction. Angel Wallace. With distinction. Thomas Charles Walsh. With distinction. Jennifer Washington. With distinction. Kyle Wiley. With distinction. Artilyar Williams. With distinction. Trinity Marie Williams. With distinction. Carmen Yildirim. With distinction.
Master of Human Resource Management.
Jennifer Allende. With distinction. Sandra Annam. Kira Bolden. Tionia White. With distinction. Michelle Castro. With distinction. Malik Dent. With distinction. Jasmine Edwards. With distinction. Norma Farfun. Shantae Fitzgerald. With distinction. Heidi Gill. With distinction. Jessica Godley. With distinction. Siham Hamani. With distinction. Karen Hampton. With distinction. Alyssa Hara. With distinction. Hara. Tornita Johnson, with distinction. Irma King, with distinction. Lakia Lewis Latin, with distinction. Jackie Mangieri, with distinction. Clorinda Oforianer, with distinction. Sarah Paisley, with distinction. Lillian Santa, with distinction. Brooke Hayden, with distinction. Zenobia Trotter, Henry White, with distinction. Demetra Williams Pitts, with distinction. Shalandra Withers,
Master of Project Management.
Cherise Archer, with distinction. Marsha Bertrand Barnett, with distinction. Tametha Denton, with distinction. Daniel Fettig, with distinction. Kareem Grant, with distinction. Gwendolyn Petway, Shruti Sanani, with distinction. Snalandra Taylor, Antonio Vera, with distinction. Dominique Verse, Monica M. Washington,
Master of Public Administration,
Debbie A. Barat-Tog, with distinction. Shoshana Brown, with distinction. Erica Kane, Lillian Flores, with distinction. Yaquavia Gooden, with distinction. Shanice Hampton, Felicia Haynes, Mariela Hernandez, with distinction. Christiana O'Allowale, Rosalind Reed, Brenda Strong, with distinction. James Tyler,
College of Engineering and Information Sciences. Master of Information Systems Management. Gerald Campbell.
With distinction.
Ben Flores.
Charles Garcia Jr.
Charles Halsey. With distinction. Jeff Krischel. With distinction. Marcellus Lacey. Carl Maggett. With distinction. Alicia Semple. With distinction.
Master of Information Technology Management.
Kovi Edem Adinsi. With distinction. Tony Catchings. With distinction. Victoria Elise Catchings. With distinction. Candace Dean. With distinction.
Master of Network and Communications Management.
Abdel Fadagashe.
Oh, I got four people reading. Did you not do it?
Mahadi Malik.
Okay, I admitted it.
Clarissa Manuel. With distinction. Nipit Pongpan.
Hello.
DeVry University. College of Business and Management. Bachelor of Science in Accounting.
Amy Austin. Amanda Sestrick Martinez. Carolina Martinez. Jennifer McNulty. Cum laude. Alicia Palmer. Summa cum laude. Holly Robertson. Magna cum laude. Ladarius Washington.
Bachelor of Science in Business Administration.
Emily Avila. Janice Banks. Rachel Bates. Martha Bell. Tamika Bradley Cooper. Brittany Elkins. Brandon Engwall. Wendy Longoria. Michelle Stewart. Magna cum laude. Daryl Ausleray. Daryl Jeremy Patino.
Jeremy Patino.
Karina Perales.
Karina Perales.
Magna Cum Laude.
Magna Cum Laude.
Brianna Phillips.
Brianna Phillips.
Summa Cum Laude.
Summa Cum Laude.
Jordan Prado.
Jordan Prado.
Denisha Puckett.
Denisha Puckett.
Saba Suleiman.
Saba Suleiman.
Cynthia Brielle
Valdez.
Yvette Vargas. Dorothy White. Mary Whiteman.
Mary Whiteman.
Bachelor of Science in Management.
Tarna Allen. Summa Cum Laude. Sherelle
Anderson.
Fazil Ansari. Magna Cum Laude.
Jorge Berrigan.
Summa Cum Laude. Melissa Clampett.
Cum Laude.
Imani Clark.
Imani Clark.
Cyrena Dowd.
Cum Laude.
Afreen Faruqi. Melat Getachew. Magna Cum Laude. Rocio Gutierrez. Anna
Higgins.
Summa Cum Laude. Precious Hill. Cum Laude. Shirley
Humes.
Summa Cum Laude. Phyllis
Jones.
David Kabanda. Shardae Kennedy. Cum Laude. Charvita King. Jessica Manning. Summa Cum Laude. Wilmer Mondesi. Jason Nelson. Summa Cum Laude. Daniel Passamit. Carly Pettis. Yvette Razzo. Summa Cum Laude. Griselda Saavedra. Cum Laude. Catherine Navarro Washington. Cum Laude. Tiffany Joyce Marie Wells. Aaron
Young.
Cum Laude.
Cum Laude.
Melissa Youngblood.
Bachelor of Technical Management.
Susan Hunter.
Bachelor of Science in Technical Management.
Gregory Acosta. Sirleda Almeida. Summa cum laude. Tia Anthony. Jennifer Aragon. Beatrice Asonganyai. Magna cum laude. Devin Austin. Cum laude. Rabia Bhajia.